This lecture is going to be about introducing you to the different categories of decimal numbers and also introduce you to complex numbers. Numbers evolve out of necessity. So the first set of numbers is the counting numbers, which evolved because people wanted to keep track of their sheep and so on. So to count, basically. So that's why they're called counting numbers. This notation is called set notation. This is capital N is used to represent natural numbers. The two curly brackets are enclosing the elements of the set. These are called elements of the set, separated by the commas. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the dot 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 represents that the numbers go on infinitely. The next set of numbers was needed because we wanted to represent the concept of nothingness, which is zero or shunya. And that concept of nothingness, along with natural numbers, represented whole numbers. We used the letter W to represent whole numbers. Notice the set of natural numbers is a subset of whole numbers. And subset just means that all of the natural numbers are also whole numbers. All right, next set of numbers is called integers, and the set of integers consists of all the whole numbers that you had before, along with their negative counterparts. You might be wondering why we use the letter Z to represent integers, and that comes from the word Zahlen in German, which means numbers. And why did we need the integers? They came into existence when you wanted to keep track of a more complex society where you have borrowing and debt. So, for example, even now in business, you might represent a debt of $50 as negative 50. All right, then comes the set of fractions, which the Greeks thought represented all numbers. And to most people's surprise, that's not quite the case. There is numbers that are also not rational numbers, but Q for quotient, and they thought that we could describe everything by quotient of numbers. So A over B, that's how you read this. This is a different notation than here, so we're going to go through it. We say A is a numerator, B is a denominator. So all numbers of the form numerator over denominator, this vertical bar means such that this means B not equal to zero. When you put a bar through something, it means not equal. So all fractions with denominator non-zero, where numerator denominator are integers, are called fractions. We can also represent rational numbers as decimal numbers. We'll see how to do that in some later lectures. They are either terminating decimals, so finite number of digits, or non-terminating with repeating pattern, like 4.3 bar. So all decimal numbers with terminating decimal notation or non-terminating repeating pattern are called rational numbers. We say irrational numbers are complement of rational numbers, or all numbers that are not rational numbers, all decimal numbers that are not rational numbers are called irrational numbers. Irrational numbers are all decimal numbers that are non-terminating with no repeating pattern, or like square root 2. So the set of rational and irrational numbers together form the set of real numbers or decimal numbers. So all decimal numbers are real numbers, and then some are rational and the others are irrational numbers. If you look now, that means that all natural numbers are real numbers, all natural numbers are whole numbers, all natural numbers are integers, and all natural numbers are fractions. How do I say 2 is a fraction? I can say 2 over 1, 4 over 2, all those are 2. So all natural numbers are all of these labels that you see here. It's a whole number, it's an integer, it's a rational number, and it's a real number. This is important to understand the words of what they mean, the categories of numbers, and how to interact in between them. All right, so now the new set of numbers, we're going to call them the set of complex numbers. So just having real numbers was not enough. People realized that, and they formed a set of numbers called complex numbers, which are of the type A plus BI, where A and B belong to real numbers. So any number of the form A plus BI, where A is called the real part, B is called the imaginary part. What is that I? That I is the value of square root negative 1. Or you can think of I to be a number whose square is negative 1. We know that no real number square is going to give you a negative value. And so I is an imaginary number. And we can write I, we can use I for square root negative 4, for example, which can be written as 2i because square root 4 is 2. So all negative square roots can be written by using the letter I. The I is not a variable, but we use a variable to represent an imaginary number. So remember, I is a number. It's a complex number, an imaginary number. So in the number 3 plus 2i, 3 is the real part, 2 is the imaginary part. So this is an example of a complex number that is not a real number. 31 is a real number, and is it a complex number? Yes, because I can write that as 31 plus 0i. So if you have 0 imaginary part, then all real numbers are complex numbers. So to make sure you understand the hierarchy and how the numbers are nested within each other, sometimes a Venn diagram, which is basically a pictorial representation of what we just did, might help. So we started with counting or natural numbers, then we had whole numbers. So 0 is a whole number that is not a natural number. Integers, you can think of negative 2 as an integer, but it's not a whole number or a natural number. Then the set of rational numbers, which was all fractions or terminating decimals or non-terminating decimals with repeating pattern. So for example, 4/3 is a rational number, but it's not an integer or a whole number or a natural number. And irrational numbers are non-terminating decimals with no repeating pattern. And then that's basically forms the set of real numbers or decimal numbers. So rational and irrational numbers together form real numbers or decimal numbers. And then we have the set of complex numbers where we have numbers of the form 3 plus 2i. And all real numbers are complex numbers with imaginary part 0, but not all complex numbers are real numbers, like the number we just talked about, 3 plus 2i. So to make more sense of numbers, it might be good if you did the following project on your own before you go to the next lecture. So pay attention to all the numbers that come in your daily life and see if you can categorize them from terminology from this lecture. We're going to do a practice problem where we give you a number and then you categorize it as whole number or integer, rational or irrational, a real number or a complex number. Let's start by pausing the video here and attempt the problems on your own. Some of you might be resistant to pausing, but do that because it's for your own good, because then we'll discuss the solutions and then you'll know whether you have them right or not. Okay, assuming you've paused the video, let's discuss negative 70. Negative 70 is not a whole number, but it is an integer. And as soon as it becomes integer, then it's going to be all of the categories that come under it, which is rational, real, complex, because set of integers is a subset of all of those. All right, 6i we know is a complex number only because of the I part. All right, 57 over 45, you have numerator as integer, denominator as integer. So you have a ratio or a quotient, which means that you have a rational number, which makes it real and complex. You have a decimal number next, 2.141441... which means it's a non-terminating decimal with no repeating pattern. So that will make it an irrational number, which then makes it real and complex. And then the next number is complex. If you have trouble understanding this slide, please stop the video, rewind. This is the benefit of watching the video lectures on your own, in your own space and time, so that you don't have to worry about how many times you have to rewind to understand something. All right, let's do more problems of the same type. Again, pause the video here and continue working on it. And then when you're ready, check your answers. Just know that square root 4 is 2. We will work on square roots later. So for right now, just assume square root 4 is 2. And then see if you can label everything. So 2 is going to be a whole number. And if it's a whole number, then it's also integer, rational, real, complex. Square root 31 is irrational, and then automatically it will become real and complex. Negative 41.3 is not an integer because of the 0.3 that it has. It is a decimal number, and terminating decimal with the 0.3. Therefore, negative 41.3 is going to be a rational number, real number, complex number. Remember, all integers are also decimal numbers, but after the decimal point, they will have no digits, just zeros. That will make integers. So 0.017 bar, again, a repeating decimal number, so it's a rational number, and therefore real and complex. How about this next one? Do you think it's a rational number since it's a fraction? Are you thinking? It looks like a fraction, doesn't it? Numerator and denominator? Well, it's not, because the square root 2 makes it an irrational number. And so once it's irrational number, it's going to become a real number and also a complex number. All right, this prepares you now to do the next set of video log questions. If the video log questions move too fast, you can always go to the book and get the questions from there, or pause the video to write these questions down.